All right, Phil and Jess, the case that we're dealing with today is something that has actually been frightening a lot of people. It's a strange case, and frankly, it's pretty unsettling stuff.
Well, you had me at frightening.
Yeah, what are we dealing with here?
Well, it's not exactly an unidentified flying object. This case involves an unidentified flying creature. Now, before you run out of the room, Phil, I want to show you a video. Check this out.
Whoa!
Maybe a bird?
Almost like a bat?
What is that?
Looks like a dragon.
Right?
I mean, those wings are huge.
Wow.
It's a dragon.
So whatever this is has not been identified, but it's one of a number of reports that people have come forward with seeing flying, often humanoid-looking creatures. And most of the people who see this stuff are terrified by it.
Well, that makes sense. I think there's something very primal in us about being afraid of giant predators in the sky.
And there's also something just naturally menacing about a dark, webbed-winged humanoid object flying through the sky. It's scary.
Well, that brings us to the case in question. People in two different parts of the country are recently reporting encounters with not just a flying creature, but the most famous flying cryptid of all time, Mothman.
Yes! I was hoping you were gonna say that.
You love Mothman.
I love Mothman.
Phil?
I don't know about this one.
This is next level, Phil. Let's bring you up to speed. It's a story that begins in Point Pleasant, West Virginia, November 1966. That's when two young couples driving home after a double date reported seeing a menacing winged humanoid creature on the edge of town. They said it had glowing red eyes, and it attacked them from the air, scratching the roof of their car as they tried to escape. Mothman sightings around Point Pleasant continued for the next year, culminating with the creature being reported on Point Pleasant's Silver Bridge shortly before it collapsed on December 15, 1967. 46 people died, and many blamed Mothman. According to reports, he was spotted in Ohio in 1975, twice in 1981 in Pennsylvania. He was reportedly seen in Kentucky in 1986, then three more times in 1994, back in West Virginia. After that, things were relatively quiet, until now. Over the last 2 years, there have been 87 sightings of Mothman in and around Chicago. And in the Point Pleasant area, in the last 3 months alone, there have been nearly a dozen sightings. So Jess, what do you make of this?
He's back, baby!
Point Pleasant is the epicenter of Mothman mythology. While thousands come from all over the world for the annual Mothman Festival, many locals see the creature as a genuine threat. And that's why they're obsessed with Mothman. And I do mean obsessed. Jeff Wamsley is a researcher who has spent decades gathering evidence about the Mothman phenomenon.
These are probably some of the rarest archives we have in the museum. These are the handwritten police reports of those original four witnesses. After they saw this thing, they went immediately to the sheriff's department.
We're trying to wrap our heads around that first incident and how
right.
it connects to all the other ones, even
exactly.
in Chicago.
So can you break down the events of that evening for us?
Sure. In November 15th, 1966, you had the two young couples. They were just riding around.
They were driving along a road that bordered the southern edge of the West Virginia Ordnance Works, a former TNT plant on the outskirts of town. That's where they encountered what they thought was a man. But as they drove closer, they saw its 10-foot wingspan and glowing red eyes. Suddenly, it took off, flying over the top of the car. Terrified, the driver tried to outrun the creature, but even at 75 miles an hour, he couldn't shake the talons that were clawing at the top of the car.
Once they got to the city limits, it veered off into a field. That was the first official local sighting here. Minutes after they came into town, they were scared enough to go to the police department. They didn't want to, but they did.
Did they sequester them all in different rooms to get
these? Yes, they did.
Got it.
I have three of those four people's original reports right here.
I saw, you know, this big bird-looking thing go over top of my car.
I could see it wasn't a man. That it looked more like a bird. Instead of arms, they were like wings.
I had a huge wingspan on it. It was at least 10 feet.
I was paralyzed.
Really?
And I just thought, well, you know, I'm going to die.
And how long did that activity, as far as the sightings, go on for before the Silver Bridge collapsed?
13 months to the day that original sighting. It's the worst bridge disaster in U.S. history.
Wow.
So I've actually hooked us up with somebody that's going to walk us through all those recent sightings. And we're going to have to go up, like, really high.
What do you mean high?
Like, Mothman high.
No Chicago structure is more iconic than Willis Tower. Once known as the Sears Tower, it is the second tallest building in the Americas and the place where eyewitnesses have reported seeing Mothman. Jessica and Phil are here to meet author and paranormal investigator...
Going up?
Tobias Wayland. Tobias has been gathering data on the Chicago Mothman sightings since he first got wind of a trio of recent reports.
Hey, Tobias.
Sorry, I'm a little late. That's a lot of stairs.
Sure is.
So why did you bring us here?
Well, it wasn't me. The Mothman did.
The Mothman, over 1,000 feet up, chose this location.
Higher, actually. The sighting that supposedly took place right here had the creature at the very top.
Wow.
There's a guy, Guillermo, and he's outside smoking just after 5 p.m. in July of 2017, and he sees something on top of the tower. And as he's standing there, this winged human jumps off of the tower.
After that, the sightings just kept coming.
And everybody sort of described the same thing, which was a large bat-like creature. We've got probably well over 100 different reports and associated phenomena.
All within this area or just across the board?
Within 200 miles of Lake Michigan.
Well, it's really interesting because Mothman always, at least the reports and stories that I've heard and read, is that it's usually in kind of rural areas. I've never heard of him in the middle of Chicago.
Let me show you a map. They're almost always centered around green spaces.
I'm really surprised at how many are in the city, too.
A lot of people probably don't realize that they are surrounded by nature, that there are owls here, there are herons here, there are a lot of big birds. And so when it's dark and they see something flying and they know that Mothman has been sighted here, maybe that's why they're thinking it's Mothman.
There isn't going to be as much physical evidence, and so the criteria I have to use to judge those sightings is the credibility of the witnesses themselves.